Article 14 of the Constitution of India, which says similar people shall be treated similarly. Merely because some of the institutions rendering help is in the garment sector and some are outside garment sector, is no ground to discriminate at all, because this is not a reasonable classification under the Constitution of India. I'm quite confident that this enactment, if it becomes an act, will not stand the scrutiny of the court even for 5 minutes, and it will be struck down. I'm not saying this just to please you all, but that is the law as I understand it today. And look at the way it has been done. They are protecting a corrupt part of the government system and trying to denigrate an honest part of the system here. Who is corrupt? The government medical service or the private medical service? Everybody knows how a government hospital functions. How many of these ministers and MLAs go to a government hospital for treatment? In spite of all this, you want to denigrate an institution where you take treatment. I hope these private institutions will not entertain an officer or a politician in their hospitals. Then they will realize what is good and what is bad. You might have seen recently, maybe last week or so, a television scene where in Meganan Hospital in Shimoga, a 71-year-old man had to be dragged by his wife to be taken to an ICU, and the government did not have a stretcher there in the hospital. You all would have seen what happened in KIMS Hubli, where a stillborn child was to be cremated and the demand was for 500 rupees to take the child from there. This is what is happening every day in the government hospital, and you are not taking any action against that, but you want to impose restrictions on a system which is as good as any other good system in this country. I have had the opportunity of investigating corruption and maladministration in this country, and I have, during the course of my 5-year tenure, noticed what all happens in a government hospital, how much money is required to be treated in that hospital. You don't even bother to look into it, you don't even bother to improve the facilities there, but a system which has come as an alternative service to the people because of the failure of the state services, you are now trying to denigrate and impose restrictions on that. Why don't you include your own service there, government services? Excuse me. Are they better than the private services? If it be so, how can private services survive in this system? I believe Honorable Health Minister has said, Dana Haigalu Mathe Rakta Hiriyoru, Anthe Helidre Anthe Yarri. ರಾಜಕಾರಣಿಗಳ ಅಲ್ಲ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಗಳ ಇಂಥ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಉತ್ತಮ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಣ್ಣು ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ದೂರ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತದೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಗಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಎ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಾಕ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಎ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವೈಲ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್ ಐ ಟು ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. The basic fundamental differentiation between the same class of people, if it's not a reasonable restriction, can never stand the scrutiny of judiciary. Let us take that two instances. What are you trying to say in this enactment? You are trying to say patients are being robbed by the private institutions. What's happening in the government institutions? There's no corruption in the government medical service. What action are you taking about it? How many doctors have you suspended in spite of the fact that it has been brought to the notice of the medical department? I don't think this enactment bears any genuineness. It is done for deliberately hiding the ill comings in the public system. I'm with you, ladies and gentlemen. So however much you want, I'll support you. Thank you very much.
I request everybody to give him a standing ovation for having given us the legal perspective.